Mr. President, ably represented, distinguished Senate President, distinguished Speaker, Right Honorable Speaker, Honorable Ministers present, very many other distinguished ladies and gentlemen, too many for me to mention, so I'll save your time, and to express my profound gratitude to be allowed to say a few words in this occasion and to welcome all of us. NMPC being one of the major contributors to hosting this event, we're happy to see this event happen today for two reasons. One is that fiscal meetings of this nature have become very rare, and I know that the industry is looking forward to gathering of this nature so that we can interact, we can move the industry forward, and also deliver value to our shareholders. Honorable Minister of State of Petroleum Resources, I'd like to congratulate you for making this work. We know that this is very, very expedient at this time, and also the very fact that this engagement in the past has produced enormous resources, too numerous for me to mention. My colleague Mike and Department Secretary have said a few words around this. We know that there are crises in the industry today. Definitely, the theme of this conference cannot be better than anyone else can imagine to say that from crisis to opportunity, new approach to the future of oil. We are aware of all of the energy transition issues that are going on across the globe. We also know the challenges that the COVID-19 has thrown at the industry and on the entire globe. And the end result is that there is depression in demand. People's choices have changed. Many things will never come back to the normal that we know. And ultimately, it will affect our business. And for us locally here, we know we have challenges around fiscal stability. So much is going on today. The distinguished Senate President and the Right Honorable Speaker are here, and the Honorable Minister, there's effort going on to make sure that the petroleum industry bill comes into play. At the back of this, there are concerted engagements in the industry with our partners, leading to even the closure of some of very difficult engagements that has become a matter of litigation between us and our partners. And we're very proud that one of such has been concluded, and it has opened a road to very many other understanding and agreement that we can meet with our partners. Of course, we also are aware that cost is everything in the future. The crisis has thrown off the fact that only the best of producers will survive, and therefore cost control becomes a major issue for the industry. Everybody is aware of this, and the industry and we and our partners are working together to make sure that this works for all of us. And of course, I know this conference will bring out the very fact that funding is a major issue in the industry today, for two reasons. One, there are paucity of resources across the globe, and secondly, there's overall reluctance by investing companies or banking authorities to even put money into fossil fuel-related businesses. This is what we have to live with, what we have to contend. But obviously, the best of the businesses that will survive are the ones that try to transit into much more climate-friendly businesses. And lastly, of course, security is a major issue for us in our business today. There are concerted efforts across the industry in the Niger Delta area and all other locations to make sure that we contend the issues of security around our assets. We are aware that significant work has been done. The level of security issues has clearly diminished, but there is still work to be done. And of course, that means much more needs to be done by all of us. And we are very proud that the work that the federal government is doing today is yielding results. And every reaction that is necessary to make sure that this works for our country is very, very welcomed by the industry. And we are completely aligned with this, with the help and support of the Honorable Minister. Lastly, to combat this crisis to advantage, this industry must work together to look at advantages that are inherent in the transition that we're going through. Every company must try to be an energy company and not necessarily an oil and gas company. That's what everybody is doing, and this is what we're also doing in the NMPC to make sure that we transform from what we are today to an energy company. And to do this, you must automate, you must reduce your costs, you must be more efficient, and also you must be more collaborative in our approaches, and this is paying off for us. And of course, ultimately, this crisis as it is today, as we face in the industry, is surely an opportunity for us to do many things differently. And particularly, more so in our country today, where the enormous gas resources can be converted to value, and we can join the journey for blue and green hydrogen. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure that as we go ahead, this conference will add more value to this conversation, and I appreciate the opportunity. Thank you very much.